possible activities from which we are going to choose and insert in the work plan and tweak and contextualize based on what you have just been discussing. So maybe Jenny can explain this.
We did two things. We gave you a comprehensive timeline of all the activities. Like, it's only a few minutes to explain this. So this is a simple list of about 60 different things that you'll do. And so the whole point is not to scare you, but say we've thought about it in great detail. It's everything from sign up on the work plan, then you're gonna get your technical assistance training gap. So you tell us where you know that you need additional faculty, you need help. We do a literature review. You refine further, like what we've been doing, the to whom, to what. You get your staff hired. You get your space figured out. You get our M&E plan. You standardize operating. So this is the level of detail that we thought it out for you. We've incorporated objectives, because sometimes objective one doesn't necessarily come before objective two and a three. And then it's also, starting on number six, what we did is we took that whole timeline and we broke it up into objectives and cross-cutting activities. So these are the things that you have to do no matter what your objective is. So no matter what objective you're looking at, you have to sign up on the work plan. No matter what objective, you've got to identify technical assistance training gaps and so on and so forth. And then further on, these are the activities by objective. So to start doing your resilience framework, literature and secondary review, training your lab staff in data collection and resilience assessment. So it's pretty detailed, but we're definitely missing some things. We even thought of some things today that are missing. What we have not filled out for you are your outcomes, your assumption, and then the resource and staffing requirements. Those are left for you guys to fill out. So do you have any questions?
So life is made easy.
So maybe just in addition, this list goes beyond the 1 year. It goes beyond the December. It digs into second year, third year. So all you have to do
and
is...
And some of them to fourth year.
Yes. So all you have to do is to identify which of those, especially those activities listed under each objective, to what extent can you move up to the time, say, September, October, November, most December.
Just to be clear, we wrote this kind of just looking at a year of activities. So if you're writing it for longer periods of time, you'll have to modify it, but that first year will be in there.
So with this, I'll then hand over to... Yeah. Any questions? So don't just copy the activities and paste into the work plan and say that it is. There's need for some process. Some of them you may not need. Some of them you may need, even in like two activities talking of the same thing, data collection like this, then data collection like this. So don't just copy and paste. But we are going to have a tete-a-tete with the lab directors to dig deeper into this. Thank you so much for this. And
give him a clap. I was told that Africans are mean with their hands. But they don't like class.
Give it to me. I don't think it's only tourist business. The mic is there. It's a question.
Yeah, you said the weeks, 1 week time is given for this activity. Hey, Rob. 1 week, yes? Is that what you are saying?
Yes.
Some of these things requires to go back to those specific areas, probably actual observation of those areas, whether they are really fit to come into this study or not. It's not simply to go to one organization and just...
It is an interview.
Stop it.
Put something, we get it moving, then we can amend, move and add. But if you put nothing, then we don't start. Yeah. Put something. Okay. Then you move. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, I think this session is over and we were supposed to stop now. But unfortunately,
there are two sessions that we forgot, which we have to go. So we may leave about 7 o'clock.
Yeah, it's our business.